Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing inverse functions. Our example is to find the inverse of f of x equals cube root of x minus 1 plus 2. Let's go ahead and work through its solution. So the first step when you're finding the inverse of a function is to replace your function f of x with y. So step one, instead of writing f of x, we just write y. So we get y equals, then here we have the cube root of x minus 1, and then we have the plus 2. Again, step one, just replace your f of x with y. Step two, you interchange your x and y. So you switch your x's and y's. So here we have a y, you call it x. And then here you have an x, so you call it y. So here we get the cube root of y minus 1, and then we have a plus 2 over here. These first two steps are really easy in every problem because all you do is you replace f of x with y in step 1, and then in step 2, you just switch your x's and y's. Step 3 is really where it can get a little bit harder. In step 3, we have to solve for y. I'm going to go ahead and write down our equation again. We have x equals the cube root of y minus 1 plus 2. And we have to solve this equation for y. The y is trapped inside this cube root. So a good first step is to isolate this cube root. But we have a plus 2 here, so we can eliminate that by subtracting it from both sides like this. Cancel. So we get x minus 2 is equal to cube root of y minus 1. So now we've isolated our cube root. So now what we can do is get rid of the cube by cubing both sides. This will get rid of the cube root. So you cube the right-hand side, cube the left-hand side. We end up with x minus 2, and that's cubed, and that's equal to y minus 1. Then we can add 1 to both sides, so plus 1 plus 1. So we end up with x minus 2 quantity cubed plus 1 equals y. And that looks weird, so usually what we do is we write the variable we're solving for on the left. So I'm going to write this as y equals parentheses x minus 2 cubed plus 1. And we're looking for the inverse, right? So we should use the correct notation. So step 4 is to just rewrite y using the proper notation. So here's the notation. It's f inverse of x. That's how you read it. F inverse of x. The parentheses is of and the negative one is inverse. So it's f inverse of x is equal to parentheses x minus 2 quantity cubed plus 1. Beautiful. This would be the inverse function of f. So what this does is it undoes what f does to x. So if f does something to x, this function undoes it, right? So it's like the opposite. In this particular example, you can actually find the inverse using a super cool mental trick. Let me show you really quick, just for fun, because this is a very powerful technique and it doesn't always work. So the original question was f of x equals the cube root of x minus 1 plus 2. So we can find the inverse using our minds, and this doesn't always work. It only works on some of the problems like this one. So if you think about what f does, what does it do? Let's write down what it does. It takes x and it subtracts 1. So I'll put sub 1. That's the first thing it does. Then it takes the cube root and then it adds 2. That's the order of operations, right? So it takes an x, it takes a real number x, subtracts 1, takes the cube root, and then adds 2. So let's undo that in reverse order. What's the opposite of adding 2? Well, that's subtracting 2. The opposite of cube root is cubing. And the opposite of subtract 1 is add 1. So let's write down the answer based off that. In fact, so we have x It subtracts 2 from the x, cubes it, and then adds 1. So you just go in reverse order. So again, your function takes x, subtracts 1, finds the cube root, and adds 2. Going in reverse order, subtract 2, cube it, add 1, and there you get the same answer. So a little bit harder to do in your head, but it works. It works sometimes. It doesn't always work. So hopefully you've learned some math in this video, and the method I showed you up here always works, right? I mean, most of the time, you'll be able to do any problem you encounter with this method. The hard part might be step 3, the solving for y. Anyways, that's it. I just wanted to show you how to find the inverse. Hopefully you learned some math. And if you did, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.